hello guys, welcome on board to a new tutorial today. It's a Canadian tropilo. So basically, from that sketch I did, we're going to be drawing a grid vertically and horizontally. The gap I am leaving is just 1 inch differences. From the picture I sent, this is how you are going to draw the lines or the illustration that will create your Canadian tropilo. After each marking, there's a space in between, and they are all facing. If you look at it, turning your phone towards the other side is supposed to form a kind of V shape. So you just watch it closely and you'll be able to notice it. So each line has a gap. I'm trying to show you the end result here. I tried to use a marker here so that we can see clearly what I did. Please don't use a marker for your real work. You can use a pen, a chalk, whatever it is. The essence of this grid is to help us to be able to sew closely. So afterwards, I take my thread and needle and I begin to sew like almost immediately. So after sewing, I join point A and point B together. This is to help me notch at the center part that creates the real design. So I notch and I secure my notch twice or as much as possible. So that's what I keep doing here. Sorry, at this point, my thread kind of hook. Don't try to put too much thread. Then I keep going to the next side. You can as well cut and start again, but I kind of feel that's going to waste too much time. So I cut, I just continue and I repeat the same process. So that's how you're going to do it continuously. For this design, if you want a rectangle shape, all you need to do is cut your bridal satin or your satin fabric 30 by 30, just like I did in my own. I use a smaller material so that we can see clearly. When I was starting out, I realized a lot of YouTubers just do directly on the fabric, which makes it very hard for camera to capture no matter how good your cameras are. So I try to use a smaller fabric so that you can see closely what I am doing and what I have done. So basically, this is just it. You just keep repeating the process all through down. I'm trying to show you what it should look like if you are doing the right thing. That's what your backside should look like or if you are doing the right thing. So I will just keep sewing my own all through. You don't need to have a sewing machine to be able to do this. A thread and needle basically is what you need for this job. And you just need patience. You just need to have all the time because this is going to take so much time. It's in realistically speaking, sometimes it takes me like 3-4 hours to finish one. When I started at first, it took me like a whole day, not mincing words. So you just have to sit carefully and just keep doing this. But you might be faster, who knows? So here again, I'm trying to show you what it looks like behind and all. And after this, I'll basically go to my machine to sew up the edges. After sewing the edges, After sewing my edges, then basically the pillow is ready. It's just as simple as that. The basic work is the fabric manipulation, which is the thread and needle part of it, but every other part of it is just very easy. So at the end of it, you can decide to use a different color material for the back side, or you can still decide to use the same material, but I like things colorful, and since yellow and black kind of complement each other, I thought to try something new and something different. So I used a hard black velvet material for the back side, and basically that was just it. And I tried to keep sewing. So another thing I want you to take note of when sewing is, for this design, when you make this design, you just have to be conscious of this pattern that you created and carefully follow it all through and sew accordingly. If not, you're going to have a very bad finishing, and when you have a bad finishing, the work is as the same as useless. So I feel I should alert us so we take this into cognizance when sewing. I just basically do this all around and leave a small opening where I can put my fillings. I use fiber fillings for this. Fiber fillings are the best for Canadian tropilo. This is what it looks like. I just had to cut out parts to show you what it looks like when I'm filling. So that's how it looks filling. I just open and I keep filling till I am done. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Do give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you're not subscribed. And of course, like.